on my heart to share was topic of knowing God, which you'll see notes in your bulletin. Today we're going to look at three things. What does it mean to know God? How do we know God? And why do we want to know God? What does it mean to know God? In the preface to Christian theology, John McKay illustrated two kinds of folks interested in Christian things. The first person sitting on a balcony of a house, watching travelers go on the roads below. The balconiers can hear the travelers talk and chat with them. They may comment critically on the way the travelers walk, or they may discuss questions about the road, how it can exist at all, or lead anywhere, and different points of view. But they're onlookers, and their problems are theoretical only. The folks walking the path are the travelers, and by contrast, they face problems. Though they may have theoretical angle, they essentially are practical problems, like which way to go and how to make it. Problems which call not merely for comprehension, but for decision and action too. Balconiers and travelers may think over the same area, yet their problems differ. In relation to evil, the balconier's problem is defined in their illogical, explanation of how evil can exist with God's sovereignty and goodness. But the traveler's problem is to master evil and bring good out of it. Or take the issue of the Trinity. While the balconier is asking how one God can conceivably be three, what sort of unity three persons could have, and how could there be three persons? The travelers want to know how to show proper honor, love, and trust toward the three persons who work together to bring us out of sin to glory. We all want to be travelers. We want to have knowledge of God, not just knowledge about God. We need to know God's attributes, the nature and character of God, his purpose, his infinity, his unchangeableness, his almightiness, his omnipresence, his perfections, the aspects of his moral character, his holiness, his love and mercy, his truthfulness, his faithfulness, his goodness, his patience, his justice. We need to know what pleases him, what offends him, what awakens his wrath, what affords him satisfaction and joy. If we are going to have a relationship with Christ, we need to seek to understand him. But there's a major difference between knowledge of God and knowledge about God. One can know a great deal about God without knowing God. One can know a great deal about godliness without knowing God. Have you ever listened to a person or preacher talk about God that you knew did not have the Spirit of God inside them? If someone asks you, what does it mean to know God? You may state the gospel clearly to them. God sent his Son, Jesus Christ, to die for us sinners. Jesus rose from the dead and created the path of forgiveness for us to reach God the Father. We come to know God through Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit via personal confession of faith. I imagine thousands of people know this. However, how many of them reflect the joy, goodness, and spirit of those who truly know God? A little knowledge of God is worth a great deal more than knowledge about God. A little knowledge of God is worth a great deal more than knowledge about God. As the psalmist writes in 119, which we read today, we seek to know God's nature not as an end in itself, but as a means to further our life in godliness, to serve the great God whose truth we seek to understand. We seek to know God's nature not as an end in itself, but as a means to further our life in godliness, to serve our great God. Our goal in attaining knowledge and studying the attributes and nature of God must be to know God better himself, to enlarge in our acquaintance with him, not simply with the doctrine of God's attributes, but with the living God. We must seek in gaining knowledge about God to be led to God. So how do we do this? How do we know God? How do we turn our knowledge about God into knowledge of God? We turn each truth we learn about God into a matter for meditation, prayer, and praise. First, we must recognize how we lack knowledge of God. Measure not what you do for the church and for others, but by how we pray and what goes on in our hearts. If you don't know this, ask the Lord to help you know. Second, we must seek the Savior. Seek and find Jesus' company. It is those who have sought the Lord Jesus till they find him who find rest for their soul. So how do we seek and find Jesus' company? We study the signs of Christ, his crucifixion, the Trinity, his person, his work, his nature, his activities, and his word. Practical steps to accomplish this? We meditate on his word. We walk in the law of the Lord. We keep his statutes. We are obedient. We praise him for his lordship, his attributes, his love for us. We hide his word in our hearts. We ask him to teach us. We repent when we sin. We learn his ways. We rejoice in his goodness and his faithfulness. We delight in the Lord. We are still and allow him to lead us in knowledge of him. When we do all these things with God's help and under God's eye, seeking communion with him. So why do we want to know God? According to Daniel 11, the people who know their God shall be strong and do exploits. They shall stand firm and take action. They will serve God in their obedience to him. Don't you want to know your Creator? What were we made for? According to Paul in Philippians, I consider everything of loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. Jeremiah 9 says it's our aim to have understanding and know God. Let not the wise boast of their wisdom or the strong boast of their strength or the rich boast of their riches. But let the one who boasts boast about this, that they have the understanding to know me, and I am the Lord who exercises kindness, justice, and righteousness on earth. For in these I delight, declares the Lord. No subject of contemplation will humble your mind more than thoughts of God. God will keep you in check. He'll keep you from getting the swollen head from having knowledge about God. He will keep you grounded, which is beneficial existing on this earth for the people that we exist with. It also expands your mind. He who often thinks of God will have a larger mind than the man who simply plods around narrowly. You'll be thinking outside the box. You'll be considering the Trinity, the end times, post-trib, pre-trib, all those things, the various theologies to be discussed. These will expand your mind, as long as you don't get caught up in theology and remain focused on your relationship with God. Knowing God is critical to our living our day-to-day lives. Knowledge of God assists us when understanding situations and making decisions. Making decisions and taking action based on God's word and intervention in your life. Bottom line, we want to know God when our life appears to shatter before us, so we can cling onto him and he can show himself to us. My personal journey in getting to know God came to a crossroad a couple times in my life. One is when he asked me to go to Kenya by myself for a period of time. And you all know about that, I've shared about that. But the first time that I really had to rely upon God's promises about what I knew about God at the time was during my first marriage when I had a miscarriage. We'd been married about 7 years, no birth control the whole time, first time I got pregnant. I wanted a baby so bad. When I had that miscarriage, I was devastated. It's times like that you need to cling on to your knowledge of God. I knew he was faithful, but did not understand why this was happening to me. I could only say, "You know best. You know my future. You are in control. And you know what is best for me." He knows the whole picture. I didn't know the whole picture. I didn't know how what turn my life would take. And he knew it was best. I had to cling to the knowledge that he loved me and he knew what was best for me. We want to know God when our life appears to shatter before us, so we can cling onto him and he can show himself to us. He glorifies himself through that. In this busy and hectic time we live in, remember one direction God's given us in Psalm 46. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth.